Air Force. People first. Mission always.
The man behind the machine is a key factor. It is the air warrior who takes the inherent risks on a daily basis to achieve the primary task of keeping the nation's sky safe. On the 85th anniversary, I convey my best wishes to all air warriors and assure all my countrymen that Indian Air Force stands as a rock solid pillar of support in our collective march to take the nation forward. Jai Hind.
The Indian Air Force has contributed immensely in thwarting attempts by hostile neighbors to our north and west, proving its mettle right from the beginning. The first test came in 1937, when it was baptized by fire on the northwest frontier. In Burma, 4 years later, the IAF played a major role in repelling Japanese forces during the Second World War on the path to victory. In October 1947, raiders from Pakistan launched an unprovoked assault on the state of Jammu and Kashmir. The IAF, with its transport planes, showed its agility by establishing a bridge to ensure that Indian soldiers and equipment reached the battlefield Srinagar to save the state from raiders. Our transport aircraft saved the day and continue to be the backbone of the Air Force even today. Then came the Sino-Indian border conflict of 1962, which saw the IAF fulfill its limited role of providing transport and logistics support to our troops all along India's Himalayan borders. Air power was not fully utilized in an offensive role in the 1962 Ops. Many historians feel that had IAF been used to its full potential, the outcome could have been very different. Again in 1965, the enemy made an unsuccessful attempt of threatening the peace at the borders. Facing an enemy armed with modern aircraft and weapons, the IAF gave a befitting reply and neutralized the threat to the nation. The 1971 conflict was the Indian Air Force's hour of glory. Within the first few days of the war, the IAF gained a favorable air situation over West Pakistan, which was exploited by the Indian Army in the crucial battle of Chamb and Longevala. In the battle for independence of Bangladesh, the IAF established total air supremacy by the end of the second day's operations. The pinpoint rocket attack on Government House, Dhaka, on the 14th of December 1971 led to the surrender of the entire 92,208 strong East Pakistani garrison and the creation of Bangladesh. In the Kargil conflict, the IAF played a key role in evicting the firmly entrenched intruders by carrying out precision strikes on enemy locations on Tiger Hill and Munthodhalu. These strikes caused severe physical and psychological degradation and paved the way for the final assault by the Indian Army. This was a joint operation at its best. IAF is invariably the first respondent in case of any crisis in country, requiring quick response, whether it is natural disaster calamity or any other government contingency within the country or abroad. IAF responded with alacrity to the flood situation in Gujarat, Rajasthan, Purnia, Gorakhpur and Guwahati. During these operations, NDRF personnel along with tons of relief material were airlifted by C-17, IL-76 and AN-32 transport aircraft, which were further distributed at the flood-affected regions by helicopters of the Indian Air Force. Mi-17 V-5 helicopters, equipped with Bambi buckets, fought forest fires in Gangtok, Thiruvananthapuram, Mount Abu and Kota. To meet the operational requirements of the IAF, DRDO has indigenously developed the Airborne Early Warning and Control System, AEWNC, fitted on board Embraer 145 aircraft. The AEWNC is a leap forward towards India achieving self-reliance in development of military capabilities and strengthens the belief of Make in India campaign. An intergovernmental agreement between India and France was signed recently for the delivery of 36 Rafale fighters. Once deployed, these would be the most advanced combat aircraft in the region. IAF utilizes attack helicopters in a multitude of combat operations, including in support of the Indian Army. The Apache, in its latest version, would operate in IAF colors, shortly bringing a tremendous amount of firepower to the battlefield. Tactical airlift operations in support of the armed forces and civil authorities during HADR will be enhanced with the induction of the Chinook. Heavy equipment like artillery guns, support equipment and armament would be easily transported into remote areas in mountainous regions. With the first Tejas squadron formed recently, the induction of this indigenous fighter is well underway. The light combat helicopter, named Rudra and designed by HAF, has the capabilities to deliver its weapon load at high altitudes and will shortly enter service with the IAF. The S-400, being procured from the Russian Federation, will act as a deterrent to enemy forces. With its massive range and ability to hunt down a wide variety of aerial platforms, the system would be a game changer in the subcontinent. With the capability of intercepting fighters, helicopters, UAVs, missiles and guided weapons, the MR-SAM, integrated with IACCS, would take care of targets at medium range. The next generation ARM is an anti-radiation missile for suppression of enemy air defenses. This weapon system can be used to engage ground-based radars or emitters. A long-range glide bomb to destroy enemy airfields. The smart anti-airfield weapon is under development by DRDO and would provide destruction at standoff ranges when inducted. This year, the IAF participated in bilateral foreign exercises at Jamnagar, Exercise Eastern Bridge 4 in January 2017 and GMT 16 at Kalai Kunda in November and December 2016. Sukhoi 30 MKI, MiG-29s, Jaguars, upgraded MiG-27 interacted with F-16s of the Royal Air Force of Oman and Republic of Singapore Air Force. Such exercises provide operational exposure and mutual exchange of ideas. An advanced landing ground at Tooting in Arunachal Pradesh was inaugurated and commencement of civil flight operations from six ALGs including Pasighat has been proposed to DGCA and AAI. The strategic location of Tooting will make it a launch pad for IAF operations in the border areas. In May, an IAF team of 12 members scaled Mount Dholagiri, the seventh highest peak in the world at 8,167 meters. Nine women air warriors took part in an all-women camel expedition in Rajasthan. The team interacted with civilians and spread awareness about Swachh Bharat and Beti Bachao, Beti Padhao Abhiyan. IAF air warriors participated in prestigious national level ultra marathon, namely the Khardungla Ultra, Run the Run and the Bhati Lakes Ultra. The first Indians to skydive over the North Pole and both North and South Poles have been air warriors. All women expeditions have scaled Mount Everest. Paramotor expeditions, 10,000 kilometer long pan-India cycling expeditions promoting Swachh Bharat, Go Green campaigns have established the sporting credentials of the air warriors. Flight Lieutenant Shikha Pandey played a pivotal role in the ICC Women's World Cup held at England this year. She is the first lady officer from the services to represent the Indian cricket team and was recently commended by Chief of the Air Staff. Marshal of the Air Force Arjun Singh passed into history this year. A fourth generation soldier, he rose swiftly through the ranks and served as the Chief of Air Staff for 5 years. It is noteworthy that he flew over 60 different types of aircrafts before retiring from service. Having served as an ambassador and as Lieutenant Governor of Delhi, he was elevated to the rank of Marshal of the Air Force in 2002. Air Force Station Banagarh was renamed Air Force Station Arjan Singh in his honor in 2016. He passed away on the 16th of September 2017. The man behind the machine is the key factor. It is the air warrior who takes inherent risks on a daily basis to keep the nation's skies safe. The IAF, by the very nature of its reach and speed, would be the first responder in any conflict. We continue to train to take on any threat and are fully prepared to undertake full spectrum of air operations and respond to any challenge in the most befitting manner.